Hey, nice ears. You get the NFL package on those?
Is that a beard or does your face have diarrhea?
Because Adam.
Adam.
Adam. Adam Sandler. Like, all right, everything's okay. Sandler's here.
Adam Sandler plays an extremely successful guy, unlike he is in real life. I think he's so caught up into that world, he doesn't want his kids to do that.
Hey, Dad, we were at the Spielberg's house yesterday. They have a 150-inch TV. Can we get one of those?
You know what? When you direct E.T., I'll get you one of those.
He has such a good sense of comedy and shooting these types of comedy.
That... Hey, Wiley, you should play too. Come on.
You suck, man.
I always thought I was the hardest worker on earth until I met him, and then I realized that I was at best second.
Luckily, I'm still friends with Adam, and we have fun hanging out.
Can you have sex when they're pregnant, or does that hurt the baby?
No, Mackenzie can, because the baby thinks he's getting a Tootsie Roll.
Yeah, but those guys had a skill that you never mastered. They knew how to pass the ball.
Oh. At least I'm not Paul Blart.
Kevin James, what is your character really?
My character is just basically a nice guy who kind of pretends he's a little bit better than he is, but he doesn't need to do that around his buddies. He finds out.
You peel back any marriage, there are secrets. Mine is, I love you. I love you very much.
Kevin James is the loveliest, yummiest, most beautiful man.
Yeah. Why do you want to see models when you can see this?
Right? My guy is very fat in the movie. He's fat and physical. That's how we do it.
Shut up!
Kevin James is the latest addition to my top 8 friends on MySpace. It's fun to always have him around because he is good and very quick.
That only works on a car. That doesn't work on a car. I get it.
What the heck?
Let it go again.
And I can get a stagger.
Chris Rock is incredible, you know, the best stand-up in the world.
I work off script all the time because I don't know any of my lines.
Chris Rock's character, his cojones are not his, belongs to his wife's.
My daughter's got to bust her hump all day to pay the bills while Dummy here stays home and cleans.
I don't know how you could talk to me like that with that ceiling fan on your head. I only let you call me Dummy because you look like Slappy White, because you look like Red Fox. You know, nobody's liked you since you left the Lakers, Shaq. You know, the Bengals still need a guard. You need to shut up before the Hunters get here.
This is horrible.
Daddy, what's that machine doing?
I was getting rid of the moss, honey.
Where's it taking them?
Hell.
Don't say that, Higgins.
Oh, I'm sorry, not hell, Mexico.
David Spade is like the quickest wit I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, he left and I'm here.
Spade's pretty funny, man.
I'm so glad that we got to work together.
Did you really sleep in the closet? You drunk?
Oh, I think so.
No. No.
David Spade plays a guy who can't settle down.
All right, I did everybody's first shot for him. Now you do the second one.
My character, again, hasn't quite grown up. And he's a little bit of a philanderer.
I love your scarves.
Thank you.
She'll be tying me up with those later.
He's not kidding.
Oh, grody.
Oh, those are long, long tugs.
See you there.
My character is muy normal. It's like I am. And my character is just obsessed with certain things to avoid, I think, emotional issues in his life.
Hi, I'm Chris Rock. No, hi, I'm Rob Schneider. And,
Could you quiet that dog, please?
Well, Rob's actually good because we get to make fun of him the whole movie.
Oh, I see what you did.
Yeah, it worked. It's good. You're right. I'm just kidding.
I didn't see that. Right.
Schneider's like hysterically funny.
Spade, your hair looks like that on Saturday night season. And yes, on weekends you can borrow it.
Do you know how to skip?
the Bronx, Mrs. Fader?
Are you kidding me? I am the best at this. Give me that.
Oh my God, baby, are you okay?
Yeah, Mom. I'm just glad to see Adam's in front.
Selma Hayek is a national treasure.
Oh, boy.
Oh,
thank you, God.
Is that what we're doing? The babysitting?
Oh, no. Who cares? We don't know these people. Get loose.
And when I arrived at the first date, I just went, oh, dear, I don't know how I'm going to do this.
Selma's the real deal. Very funny. Very funny woman.
Is this what you wouldn't?
Oh, my God.
Well, she's like a broad sense of humor. She gets it.
Over there. You want me to come up? Come on. I got it. You're very flexible. You can do that. That's what they did. Okay, this is the
front
of your body.
There
you go.
Got it.
Perfect.
So, Mama. What else there to do around here?
Oh, sure, honey. Let me just.
Maria Bello. She's very at ease as an actress, and she just fit right in with these guys.
Maria, what I worked with before, I knew that I was funny for a living.
We're going to Milan tomorrow.
Oh, no, that's a shame. Oh, but you're going to have so much fun in Milan. Yeah. You know, J-Lo and Mark Anthony vacationed there last year, and it's right up the street from Lake Como, where George Clooney has a villa.
I'm
getting pulled away.
Maya Rudolph, very funny.
Sometimes I'll be in a meeting, and I'll feel him kick, and without even thinking about it, I'll just slap my belly and say, you better cut that shit out or I'm gonna start smoking again.
I'm a huge fan of Maya. She's like the best female comedian out there.
Ooh, if I'd have known we were going to the Golden Globes, I would have aired out my G-string. I would have worn my good boobie tassels. I would have taken the turd out of my diaper.
It's not my fault.
The good thing about that is in a movie like this with all these people, none of them have egos. So that's been easy.